Hello, Warren Grove Town students. Today we're going to continue with our devotionals about the fruit of the Spirit. And a couple years ago, I memorized the fruit of the Spirit along with the sign language to go along with it, and it really helped me to remember it. So I'm going to give you a challenge today. Any student that memorizes the fruit of the Spirit and the sign language that goes along with it, and next time we're together, if you can show me, then you will get a prize. So, Galatians 5, 22 through 23. But the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Against such things there is no law. So that is the fruit of the Spirit, and it's important to note that this is fruit of the Spirit. It's God working through us. It's not something we can do on our own. So we need to pray and ask the Holy Spirit to help us. And today I'm going to talk to you about goodness. And Ephesians 2:10 says, "For you are God's masterpiece, created in Christ Jesus for good works that God has prepared beforehand that you might walk in them." And this verse tells us that God has gone before us and he has prepared good works that he wants us to do. And an analogy for that is Mr. Josh and I, we like to go on a lot of walks. And there's one walk that we like to go, but the problem is that it crosses a creek and there's no bridge. So Mr. Josh, being the kind husband that he is, he will take these big boulders and he'll throw them into the creek so that I can walk across on the boulders and not get all wet and muddy. And that's exactly like God does for us. He goes before us and he prepares good works that we could do them. So I'm going to give you a challenge. And I know we've talked a lot about doing good to your neighbors, loving your neighbors, reaching out to them. But I'm going to give you a different challenge this week, and you might find this one even harder. I want you to love your closest neighbor. You know, the person sleeping in the bedroom down the hall from you, the person in the bunk bed underneath you. Yeah, your family, the people that you've probably been with a lot lately. You might be getting on each other's nerves. I want you to love them. I want you to love your closest neighbor, and I want you to purposefully do something good for each person in your family and ask God to show you what that would be. Maybe it would be playing a game with your younger brother or sister that you don't really like, but you know they love to play it. Unloading the dishwasher, taking out the trash for your mom and dad without having to be asked and doing it with a good spirit. Do something good for each person in your house. And I want to leave you with one final thing. And if you hear nothing else, I want you to hear this. We can do good to people because God first showed us what goodness is. John 3:16 says that God so loved the world. And it could be said because God was so good to the world that he gave his one and only son, that whoever believes in him will not perish, but will have eternal life. God has been so good to us that he didn't withhold his own son, but he gave his son up to die the death that we deserve for our sin, to take the punishment for our sin upon himself on a cross. And if you don't have a relationship with Jesus and you don't know what I'm talking about, I would love to talk to you. That's why the volunteers, that's why we volunteer, that's why we're here. Any of the leaders I know would love to talk to you about that. There's nothing more important that we could ever talk to you about than how to have a relationship with God. And I want you to know he loves you and he has been so good because he gave his son for you. And I want to say, I miss you. I love you. I can't wait until we're together again. God bless.